A very good morning to all of you listeners. Welcome back to your own channel. And today we are at the 188th day of your godly blessing. Before we go ahead, have a look for the new listeners who have come over here at the link above here, which takes you to flexibility, yogasans, diet and sleep patterns. So enjoy yourself and let's have a look at today's blessing. What does Baba have to say in today's blessing? Baba talks about being double light, means lighter in our mind and as light in terms of being a soul or being soul conscious. Let's understand the meaning of it in depth. What does Baba have to say today? So Baba says, may you be a karma yogi. Karma yogi means somebody who is in yoga or in union with God the Father. Considering myself or considering yourself as a soul, only then can we be in connection with God the Father, the Supreme Source, the Supreme Being, the Supreme Light. So I am light, a point of light, a divine being, and God is also light. So that is what it means to be in yoga. So karma yogi means somebody who is doing their karma, being in consciousness of God. That means we know that God is giving us the guidance, giving us the virtues and the powers which we need to utilize to do that karma so that it doesn't turn into a sin. That is what it means to be a karma yogi. And while remembering God, if we do karma, then our past life sins or past life karmas or the past karmas are also washed away. So, an experience, the karmatit stage by becoming double light. Karmatit means somebody who doesn't even have any kind of feeling while doing any karma. That means you are neutral totally. Neither do you have a feeling of I'm doing a good karma, nor do you have a feeling of, oh, I hope I'm not doing a bad karma. The sanskars, the habits have turned or have turned in such a manner that you don't even have that thought whether I'm doing the right karma or wrong karma. The habit has become of doing the right karmas all the time. So that's what God wants us to do, that we stop thinking about whether we are doing right or wrong. We are doing neutral karmas. We are neutral in our mind about it. We already know it's become a habit of ours. So let's get into the explanation part of it. Just as it has become natural to come into karma, for us it's from childhood, we are doing karmas. We learn how to do, what not to do, right? In the same way, let it also become natural to become karmatit. Karmatit, as we have understood, somebody who doesn't get into the feeling, somebody who's so pure and so divine from within, and that's the process where our habits have become to do good always, to think good always, to see good, to listen to good, to speak good always. And that becomes a habit, so much so that we don't even come to know what is a bad karma or what is a good karma. So we are in the neutral stage, and that is what is known as karmati stage. So Baba then says, for this remain double light. In order to be double light, consider yourself to be a trustee while performing actions and practice soul conscious stage. So double light means two forms of light. I'm a soul, I'm a light, I'm a soul who's getting this work done. I'm not Parampreet, I'm not Shanu, because if I think of myself as Parampreet Shanu, then all the different lineages come along. That means this belongs to me, that belongs to me, my name is on this thing, my name was on that thing. I have done that work, I should be given the laurels, I should be acclaimed, I should acclaim all those things. So all that goes away with the name. So if I am a soul, I am just transitioning. And the second thing which God has said is that one is soul conscious stage. That means we don't come into any form of disparity amongst each other. And second thing Baba wants us to do is that be a trustee. That means I can be lighter when I consider everything around me as not my own. I'm just transitioning, but I'm a trustee. I'm a trustee of this house. I'm a trustee of the property. I'm the trustee of the money which God has given. As it is, we say everything has been given by God. So when somebody gives you something to take care of it, it doesn't belong to you, right? So nothing belongs to us. We leave a body, everything which we say is mine or my, it all goes away. My body also goes away. My house also goes away. So what are we then? We are a trustee. So how does a trustee work? How does a trustee think? Does he get jealous? No. Does he get into the ego of everything is mine? Does he have the ego of I'm rich or poor? No. So a trustee is somebody who doesn't get into those kind of feelings or negative impure feelings or I'm right or everything belongs to me. What about my part? What about my share of, you know, that's what is happening in the world today. Brothers of brothers are fighting. Sisters are fighting amongst each other. Brothers, sisters are fighting amongst each other for the property. people are fighting amongst each other for the property. Why? Because everything is all about my. So God says, when you're a trustee, whatsoever you deserve, you get. Apart from that, everything belongs not even to that other person, because that person is also going to leave and go. It belongs to this very earth. It stays over here. And God has given us that. So what is mine? Where is mine? So even this body, we can't say this is my body, because it's going to be left someday. So what are we fighting about? So then God says, be double light. So feel lighter by being like this. But if instead of that, if you go into my, everything is mine, then everything becomes more jumbled up. Relationships get spoiled up. And our mind gets into manipulation. Our mind gets into difficulties. Our mind becomes conniving. Our mind becomes egoistic, jealous, and so many different things come over and we start sinning. So double light makes us somebody who's not sinning, somebody who's doing pure karma, somebody who's bringing about peace in the family, peace in the world. So Baba then says, by paying attention to these two things, you will become karmatit in a second. That means we won't be even thinking, am I thinking greedy? Am I thinking egoistic? All those thoughts will also go away, because the habit would be to not to think greed, not to think jealousy. We'll be content. We'll be completely uncompetitive with others. We'll be content with ourselves. We'll be relaxed. We'll be peaceful with our own mind. And that is a state of karmatit. We won't be understanding or trying to understand what is right, what is wrong. Let people do the karmas. Let people do something wrong. That is their own thing. We won't even look into whether they are doing something wrong or right, whether they are being greedy. I'm not greedy, but they are being greedy. I don't want it, but they are taking away everything from me. Well, that is their karma. So God says that is being karmatit. When you can't even understand what is right, what is wrong. You have the knowledge of it, but you are not seeing what is right, what is wrong. You are not reiterating it. You are not talking about it. You are not spreading it. And when you are doing your karma from your own side, forget about others. When you are doing your karmas, you have become so pure within yourself that everything which you touch becomes gold. That means everything which you do becomes naturally good and nobody can complain about it. We have to reach that stage. God wants us to be that. So Baba says, become karmatit in a second and a karma yogi in a second. In order to perform actions just for the sake of it. Perform actions just for the sake of it. No feelings attached to them. I did it. My idea. I am the one who always does it right. I have the knowledge of it, that I goes away. That's where leadership comes. That's where other qualities of loyalty, royalty, leadership, acceptance, having everybody put their bit into it, all those qualities come. But if we're all about my idea, my thing, my way, then we are a loner in this world. So Baba says, just for the sake of it, as an instrument. So I'm just an instrument. I'm just getting it, and I'm just a guitar. God is playing the strings, and I'm somebody who's supposed to just take out the sound of it. So I'm just an instrument. That's it. And Baba says, be a karma yogi and then experience the karmatit stage. So if the guitar starts thinking on its own, what will happen? You are playing it, you're playing the guitar, but the guitar is thinking, having its own mind. God says, stop having your own mind. Follow my dictates, follow my methods, and you'll become karmatit, and you'll be able to leave your body in peace and go back up. So that is what Baba wants us to do, to become double light. Soul as a light, and nothing belongs to me. I'm just a trustee, lighter in a mind. And I, the soul, I'm performing the karma through this body. So nothing belongs to me. I'm a non-physical entity. The body is physical, through which I'm getting things done on this physical plane. But I'm a non-physical entity who doesn't own anything on this earth. So that makes us very light while doing any karma. Think about it. Try to practice it. And let's see what happens. And leave your comments. If you have any kind of experience, do let us know what you feel about it. So I leave you with this blessing. Have a blessed day. Stay safe. Stay home. Om Shanti.